but I've missed sort of most of first year. Second year was very strange, but hang on, I'm meant to be in third year. I'm meant to know that I can't feel like this. And it's kind of offering them that reassurance that it's perfectly normal and okay to feel like this is all very alien in your third year.
I think what the challenge from my perspective is, I think, to realise that not everyone is going to be moving on at the same rate, and that everyone is going to be keen to embrace kind of life back to normal. But some people, that's going to be slower for some people than others. It might be health reasons from the point of view of, you know, something like long COVID or something like that. Or it might be, you know, there are so many things that people might have experienced, like, you know, the bereavements or, you know, ill health or financial problems, you know, or anything like that. And I think we just have to remember that, you know, we're all keen to embrace all the new stuff and to move on and to get past COVID and to kind of, you know, steam ahead and all of that. But that's going to be easier for some people than others.
So I think people say about splitting the day into three sets of 8 hours, so obviously getting enough sleep, which I think during my time at university I haven't always achieved. Spending enough time on your academics as well, so you don't end up in a position where you've got an exam and you're trying to cram a whole term's worth of content over a weekend. But also doing things you enjoy, whether that's sporting activities, more social type things as well. It's just making sure that you get enough time to do all the things you enjoy, but also get some your real productive time at university as well.